What's going on, guys? This is Grimjow. I'm back at you with another video today. Today the ban list just dropped, and to be honest, I already seen it from a friend's chat group I'm with, and to be honest, I kind of just, instead of doing like a more of like a reaction, but I kind of just want to do more of just like to talk about it a little bit, since I kind of already know what it is. So going through this, my initial thoughts where they were gonna probably ban Dragoon, or at least affect Dragoon in some kind of way. Maybe Verte Anaconda. I was kind of looking at that card, just because of how much of a facilitator it is. But going through this, I was kind of surprised, because at least like through the monsters, I would have expected at least like maybe something to get hit there as well. But going through there kind of shocked me, and then as I kept going through further and further more, and nothing I saw, I was still gonna say this is probably just more of like a very, very small ban list then. And the first thing I saw was Zodiac Barrage. I honestly didn't really think too much of this, since it was already kind of like a really weird sacky one of that helped like Tri Brigade, or like at least any kind of other deck that would run Zoo in as a Zeus fodder. But even then, this is kind of, I guess, a nice hit to their consistency, but like to like the sacky nature of this card. But it's not the worst. Definitely more or other stuff could have gotten a hit, but you know, it is what it is. If I didn't really expect this one, I thought they were gonna like do, maybe either ban this card outright or just at least hit something else of Drytron in a way. Maybe one of the monsters or one of their spells. But even then, their other negation to put up with Herald of Ultimateness, they could just actually just use the other one, Herald of Perfection, I believe, to do all their negation. So I don't really see this as a worthy hit. It just means like less times that they can use it, because some of the combos you'd use two of them to search out either extender or a negation. Either at times it would have been double negation or whatever it would be, and you could do that on your end phase and on your opponent's turn, which was kind of, if you had that kind of hand, you just essentially just won the game. Mew Mew, this could have probably been the parrot I would have liked a little bit more, because at least it lowers the at least the play of having the +3 off of the link 2. But I guess in a way, the link 1 is also a good hit as well, because it matters the amount of times that they can just have their one card starters, and how many times they can commit to that kind of play. It, you know, been nice, but I think the recursion of the parrot, I think, in my opinion, is the worst offender for that. But you know what, the power of link one monsters, I can definitely see how they're a unhealthy thing for archetypes to have like these type of just generic monsters that like any they're how many times they're abused. Tanky, this is kind of a nice hit with like Rota. So like you don't have like just like a generic like a more than one type of like generic searcher for like other monsters. In a way, this is a hit to Tri Brigade, but it's the main thing I wanted them to have more hit was Revolt. I feel like the reoccurrence of that card just made it really not good. Like in a way, yeah, they can't do it multiple times, and at most you would only just use it once, because since they already do run a slew of traps. But even then, this would have been a little bit more nicer. The rest, like Nessie, really doesn't matter. Teleport is actually kind of nice, because it's a buff to Drytron, and I believe there's like a new archetype coming out that's also psychic as well. So maybe this might actually probably go to 3 at some point. But Emergency Teleport is a nice card to have just as like a nice generic extender for other decks where you don't have to like commit your normal summon, which is kind of nice for virtual worlds, since I believe it's Lulu and Lao Lao and like the other the two three level three psychic monsters that they have. So this is a nice way to so you don't commit your normal summon right away. Pendulums like nice, I guess, in a way. If you could literally just unban like five, six other cards as well, and it would absolutely do nothing, even as long as the Electrumite doesn't stays banned. But yeah, this does like absolutely nothing. Just yeah, this overall list was like okay. I wouldn't say it's like the worst, but a lot more could have been cleaned up on there. So okay, well, this is the end of the video, guys. Interesting list we had today. I think definitely a lot more could have been done, but other than that, yeah, it's whatever. So, alrighty, guys, have a good one.